Next experiment is COD of the given wastewater sample, that is chemical oxygen demand. It is the amount of oxygen required for the complete chemical oxidation of organic and inorganic matter present in the wastewater sample by using a strong chemical oxidizing agent like potassium dichromate. For that we are starting the demo. Part A is preparation of a standard solution. The salt here is a FEI salt. Ferrosammonium salt will be given to you. First we have to wash all the apparatus cleanly with the distilled water, then weigh the given salt and transfer it to a cleanly washed 250 ml volumetric flask and add 1 test tube of the given 1:1 sulfuric acid. You have to add first H2SO4, then you should add water. First you should add sulfuric acid to the salt, then you have to add the water. We are adding H2SO4 to prevent the hydrolysis of FeSO salt into ferric, the FeSO into ferric salt. We are adding H2SO4. Then next step, when you prepare the solution up to the mark, you will be getting a solution like this. I have already made this. Okay, after making up to the mark, you have to mix it very well and fill in the burette. Very simple. Weigh the salt, transfer it over 250 ml volumetric flask. Add 1 test tube of H2SO4. Make up the solution accurately up to the mark. Mix it well and fill in the burette. Okay, so part A is over. Part B is, we have to pipette out 25 ml of the given wastewater sample. Wastewater sample, and we should also pipette out 25 ml of the oxidizing agent potassium dichromate. After all the solution run down, you have to touch the tip of the pipette 2 to 3 times to the bottom of the conical flask and then add 1 test tube of H2SO4 containing silver sulphate and mercuric sulphate. Silver sulphate acts as a catalyst in oxidizing some of the organic compounds and mercuric sulphate is added to bind the chlorates which is present frequently in wastewater samples, and then we have to add a few drops of ferrine indicator. This is ferrine indicator. Its chemical composition is ferrous 1,10 phenanthrolein sulfate. And important here is you have to add for all the trials, same amount of indicator has to be added. Okay, so you add for each trial 6 drops. 6 drops of indicator you have to add. 6 drops of indicator added. It's important to note that for all the trials, for all the 3 trials, you have to add equal amount of indicator. 6 drops, it's enough. Now you will get an initial color like this. This is called a dirty green color, or this is also called as a bluish green color. Bluish green or dirty clear green, it's called as a. Now we have to titrate against the standard FeSO solution taken in the burette until we get a reddish brown color, almost similar to the indicator color we will be getting. Okay, so what and all we have taken? We have taken 25 ml of wastewater, 25 ml of potassium dichromate and 1 test tube of the sulfuric acid containing silver sulphate and mercuric sulphate and 6 drops of indicator. You will get this initial color Now titrate against the standard FeA solution taken in the burette to get a reddish brown color. When the titration proceeds, the dirty green color will be there. It will be something like bottle green color. It will be turning into. You should keep on adding drop wise. You are almost near to the end point now. You have to add very carefully drop wise. So this is the end point you will get. For the last drop you will add, you will be getting a reddish brown color. This is the final color. And note down the burette reading. I got around 21 ml. In the same way, you have to look at final burette reading 21. Trial 2 and 3 also should be done. You have to do 3 trials. 3 trials you have to do. And then coming to the calculation part, in the same way you have to record 3 trials, okay, and you must get concordant readings. And then coming to the calculation part, first you have to calculate the normality of the given FeA salt. First you have weighed the salt taken, right? W1 minus W2 you have to take, that will give you the weight of the FeA crystals given. You have to multiply by 4 divided by equivalent weight of the FeA, that is 392.14. So it will be like this. Weight of the salt given, it may be 4 grams, 5 grams, whatever the salt you got, weight of the salt into 4 by 392.14. When you multiply, you will be getting the Z normal. You will get Z normal. Then, after completing the 3 trials, any one trial you are taking here, any one trial value you have to take, you should not have to take all the 3 average, okay? Any one value you are considering as a X, volume of FeA consumed for sample titration is equal to X. And volume of FeA for blank titration is y ml. This will be given in your exams. You don't have to perform blank titration. Blank titration value will be given to you in your exams. What is blank titration means? It is similar to the back titration, but it does not contain wastewater sample. Anyway, this value will be given to you. Okay. So coming to the calculation part, 8 into y minus x. Y is a blank titration value which is given. X is a burette reading what you got here. Z is the normality what we calculated there, into 1000 by 25 will give you dash milligrams of oxygen per dm³. So finally we will get a dash milligrams of oxygen per dm³. This is the amount of oxygen required for oxidizing the organic and inorganic impurities which is present in the wastewater sample.